Hi guys, welcome to the fourth episode of Exploring Fauna. Before moving ahead, I would like to thank all of you a lot for loving and appreciating our Teacher's Day special video. If you have not watched that, I've linked it here. You can watch it. The link is also there in the description, so you can watch it from there as well. So we made a Teacher's Day special video, and that video has reached 1k views. It is our first video to have reached 1k views. So thank you so much, all of you, for that. Now let's get started with exploring fauna. Today we are going to talk about mammals of India. So what are mammals? Earlier, people thought that every four-legged animal is a mammal. But is that enough as a classification for all mammals? Us humans are also mammals, but we do not have four legs. So that was not a very sure shot proof that every four-legged animals can be categorized as mammals. But eventually, the mammals are classified as animals that have mammary glands or glands that produce milk for the young ones to be nourished. For example, cow. A cow has mammary glands, and the young cow, that is the calf, it feeds on that milk after it is born. It feeds on its mother's milk after it is born. So these animals that have mammary glands are called mammals. Apart from the mammary glands, there are some features that are again found only in the mammals. One of them is body hair. So, no other animal in the animal kingdom has body hair other than mammals. All mammals have hair on some parts of their body at some stage of their life. So, two characteristics we learned so far: mammals have mammary glands and mammals have body hair. The third characteristic that a mammal has is that they do not lay eggs. So birds, insects, fishes, all of them, they lay eggs. Even reptiles lay eggs. But mammals, they do not lay eggs. They directly give birth to a young one. We'll quickly revise all three features that we learned on how to classify mammals. One, they have the mammary or milk producing glands. Two, they will have body hair. At some point in their life, they will have body hair. And three, they do not lay eggs. They give birth to the young ones directly. So now we are going to take a look at a very simple term, that is rare. We are going to learn the difference between two terminologies that are probably exchanged a lot of times, but are they really exchangeable? Rare and endangered. These are the two terminologies that are often considered as the same, but they are not. Rare means a particular species who is found only in a particular area or is difficult to sight. Whereas endangered means that species is leading towards extinction. Now, what is extinction, you may ask? Extinction means the vanishing or the disappearing of a particular species from a particular area. So now we are going to see examples of rare, endangered, and extinct species in our next slideshow. I hope that cleared your doubts about what rare and endangered species are. Now let's take a look at some of the really mind-blowing facts about mammals that you did not know. Whales and dolphins are mammals. they are not fishes. They are easily misunderstood as fishes because they live in water, they have fins, they do not have legs. And mainly that basically. That is enough for people to misunderstand them as fishes. But they really are mammals. Okay? So keep in mind, whale and dolphins are mammals, they are not fishes. The very first mammals that were found on Earth were called Morganucodontids. I hope I'm pronouncing it right, you can read the spelling here. These were tiny shrew-like creatures who lived around 210 million years ago, and there were multiple lineages of these creatures. So they lived in the dinosaur times, and one of these lineages continued, and all the mammals have derived from that one lineage that has continued over the years. And we have also derived from these creatures. Now all of you must know which is the largest mammal of India. Comment the answer below without searching for it. So I will tell you about the smallest mammal of India. It is called the hog-nosed bat. It is the size of a bee and it weighs around 1.5 to 2 grams, which is like smaller than or maybe lighter than your car keys, I think. So yeah, the smallest mammal of India is hog-nosed bat. I'm sure these facts blew your mind. And you must have assumed that by the mammals that we saw so far, that mammals are mainly found in forests and jungles. Of course, but there are some mammals that are found around you as well. Just as we spoke in the beginning of this section that most mammals are found in habitats like forests or jungles. So recently there are a lot of increasing cases of human-animal conflict. What does human-animal conflict mean? Human-animal conflict means any situation in which animals and humans are facing problems because of each other. So there are a lot of cases where animals come in the farms or villages of other people and they destroy the villages or people are being killed. So one of the biggest reasons behind this is animals are not coming into our homes. We have actually entered animals' homes. We have cut a lot of jungles that were existent previously to build cities, to build factories, to build roads. And now the animals have nowhere to go. So they obviously entered these expanded cities and they are creating a havoc for the humans. So go ahead, read about it. This is all that we are going to tell about animal-human conflict. If you want a video on that, comment below and let us know. So in Exploring Fauna series, there are about 2 more episodes left. I want you all to comment below and tell me which series do you want to see next. Thank you. So I told the contest question for today in the middle of the video. Today's contest question is, which is the largest mammal of India? Okay, I'll repeat the question. Which is the largest mammal of India? It's quite easy and obvious actually. You don't have to search the internet. You just have to comment the answer and let me know. So if you like this video, then please like, share, comment and subscribe to Nature Shala.